Hi guys, welcome to Food and Living. Today let's see how to fold gowns, lehengas, anarkalis and skirts. To start with, I'm showing how to fold an anarkali. We'll take the anarkali and place it upside down. That is, the back will be facing towards you. And then we'll collect all the gairas of the gown. That is, all the flares of the gown like this. Gather them together and fold all the both the hands inside, just like I did, and start folding them into smaller folds like this. This became very compact. Likewise, we'll be folding the pant also. Bring all the edges together so that it is of this uniform width, and then you can fold it like this. This is also part of the KonMari method of folding, and you can place the pant inside the gown, inside the anarkali itself. And this is the gown. Similar to the anarkali, we'll fold this gown. As you can see, when this has a lot of ghera, that is a lot of flare. Similar to that, we'll place it upside down. That is, the back will be facing towards you. And again, you'll gather all the length of the gown and bring them together slowly, like this. Once you've gathered everything together, you'll start folding it slowly like this into smaller folds until you have the desired length, where the top is just visible like this. You can also place the bottom and the dupattas, if it is there, like this, fold it and then tuck it inside so that you can easily find it. This is a lehenga. As you can see, when this is a lot of ghera. And then it has some lace borders here. Even if it has some work, you can also fold them like this. Any tassels going on, you can also place them inside and gather all the gairas like this. And fold the upper part very thin and then start folding them inside. Inside this, we'll place the blouse. Close all the hooks of the blouse. Fold it into this size and then keep it. If there is any dupatta present, here that this dupatta has some work, so I folded it on the reverse side and then placing it inside. To store this, you can also hang them in these kind of bags with a hanger, or you can store them in a single sari organizer or single organizers like this. Because it is transparent, you can easily see through and you can know which lehenga is present or which dress is present in each bag. You can also stack them one above the other, or you can place them in file system. Similarly, I have folded another lehenga which has a lot of flares with its blouse and dupatta and the tassels also in the same bag. And then you can also place the bottoms, if any, present in the bag. Another way to store the silk cloths is into these kind of bags, folded into one. So that will again go into the organizer. And that way you can store up to 5 or 6 or even 8 dresses in the same bag like this. So this way you can save a lot of space and store so many dresses and lehenga and gown very easily. Coming to the dresses which have a lot of mirror work or stone work on it, like this, you will fold it like this. Just the work will be facing upwards. You'll place the dupatta and the bottom like this so that the work is very safe and clean. And you can place these kind of air fresheners inside for freshness. And this is how easily you can store and fold all your dresses, lehengas and gowns. Thanks for watching, guys. Please do subscribe to my channel and watch me on